All right, so there is a lot of stuff to talk about in today's video. First things first, the next Dokkan Festival exclusive unit on JP has officially been revealed, and it's going to be a new Kid Goten and Kid Trunks as one card, which is pretty awesome. I would say I am definitely excited for them, but in my mind, the big thing is still about 2 weeks away when both Global and JP get the same day unit and the same day banner. So to me, this is more of a filler celebration, if you will, a filler banner. Although, that's not to say these guys can't be broken. You know, like the Kid Goten and Trunks, man, could be mad broken for all we know, and I'm still excited to see what they can do, what their animations look like, all that stuff. And we should be getting all those details very soon as well, because this is the Dokkan event notice, right? And that means they're probably going to be dropping in about 2 days, so the details should be revealed on Twitter within the next 24 hours. So definitely stay tuned for that. And let me know in the comments if you guys are excited for a, you know, Dokkan Fest Goten and Trunks. All right, so that is the first bit of information. Let me just quickly make my game disappear. There we go. Second thing is that JP is also going to be getting 3 new Extreme Z Awakenings with the next campaign for the summonable Bio Broly movie units. The first one is the AGL Super Saiyan Kid Goten, and then we have the Fizz Super Saiyan Kid Trunks, and finally, my girl STR Android 18 is also getting an EZA. So let's check out what these EZAs actually look like, and for all 3 units, we will start with the pre-Extreme Z Awakening details first, and then talk about the EZA or Extreme Z Awaken details, so you guys can compare the two. Alright, so starting with Goten, his leader skill is AGL types key plus 2, attack and defense, or sorry, HP and defense plus 70%, super attack, supreme damage, raises attack for 3 turns, and passive is attack plus 90% at the start of the turn. So that's what he currently does. With the Extreme Z Awakening, his leader skill becomes AGL types key plus 3, HP attack and defense plus 100%, super attack, supreme damage, and raises attack and defense for 6 turns. And then passive is attack and defense plus 100% plus an additional attack plus 100% when performing a super attack. All allies attack and defense plus 18% plus raises chance of performing a critical hit and reduces damage received by 18% when there is an ally whose name includes Trunks, Kid attacking in the same turn, or when there is a Krillin or Android 18 on the team. So of course there is a lot of stuff going on here, but basically he becomes much, much, much better. And I really like it, man. I think they did a really good job with this EZA. I mean, they've been doing a great job with most EZAs these days, honestly. As you can see, for the leader skill, obviously a lot more usable. The previous leader skill was key plus 2 and no attack at all. So now it's key plus 3, HP attack and defense plus 100%, which means that he's going to be a viable leader for events like Battlefield, for example. And then his super attack raises both attack and defense for 6 turns, which means that it can be stacked multiple times. And his passive gives him some more defense, some more attack when performing a super, a little bit of support, and also some more critical hit chance and damage reduction if you have Trunks on rotation or just Krillin and 18 or 18 on the team. And one final bit of information here, his additional attack plus 100% is actually calculated separately, which means that he gets a total boost of 336% attack when all conditions are met. So this kid is going to be hitting pretty damn hard, okay? Because, I mean, first of all, 336% attack is huge, but he also gets better stats with the EZA. So he's getting up to 15,383 attack, 16,664 HP, and 12,012 defense. So both offensively and defensively, he's going to be quite impressive. I expect him to put up at least like 3 million plus attack when rainbowed with you know, Trunks on rotation. And defensively, he's probably going to be tanking pretty well because he's getting, you know, the defense on his super, defense on his passive, and also 18% damage reduction, which is not a lot, but it does make a pretty big difference. So that's the Goten for you. Moving on to the Trunks, who is almost identical with like minor changes. So pre-Extreme Z Awakening, his leader skill is Fizz Types Key plus 2, HP and Defense plus 70%, Super Attack, Supreme Damage, raises attack for 3 turns, and passive is attack plus 100% when performing a Super Attack. Extreme Z Awakening, why can't I talk right now, man? What's going on? Leader skill becomes Fizz Types Key plus 3, HP Attack and Defense plus 100%, Super Attack, Supreme Damage, and raises attack and defense for 6 turns. And passive is attack and defense plus 100%, plus an additional attack plus 100% when performing a super attack. All allies, attack and defense plus 18%, plus raises chance of performing a critical hit and reduces damage received by 18%. When there is an ally whose name includes Goten, Kid, attacking the same turn, or when there is Krillin or Android 18 on the team. So like I said, man, pretty much the exact same details, just switch AGL with Fizz and switch Trunks with Goten here, and you know, there's no difference really. And just like Goten, it's 336% attack boost when all conditions are met. So these two kids, man, are gonna make for a really fun rotation, just like the other two, Super Saiyan Goten and Trunks, is the tech one and the int one. Yeah, those two also boost each other when they're on the same rotation, so similar deal here, except they're a little bit more usable without each other, because if you have, you know, Krillin or 18 on the team, you don't actually need, Goten or Trunks on the same rotation, right? So, yeah, both EZAs are looking awesome, and finally, let's check out my girl 18 once again. You guys know, man, every single time an Android 18 comes out, or you know, an older 18 gets Extreme Z Awakening, I'm just really happy. I'm just really, really happy. Okay, so pre-Extreme Z Awakening, their leader skill is STR and Fizz types, keep plus 3, HP attack and defense plus 30%, super attack, supreme damage, and raises attack for 6 turns, passive attack plus 50% at the start of the turn, plus an additional attack and defense plus 50% when HP is 50% or above. Now, EZA, leader skill is STR and Fizz types, key plus 3, HP attack and defense plus 90%, super attack, supreme damage, and raises attack and defense for 6 turns. And her passive is attack and defense plus 100%, plus an additional attack plus 100% when performing a super attack. All allies, key plus 3, attack and defense plus 30%, plus raises chance of performing a critical hit, and reduces damage received by 18% when there is an ally whose name includes Trunks Kid, Goten Kid, or Krillin on the team. So her passive is actually very similar to Trunks and Goten as well, except it's better because she's giving more support, right? Key plus 3, attack and defense plus 30% compared to just attack and defense plus 18% for all allies. And then she's also getting the same critical hit chance, getting the same damage reduction, but you don't need any specific unit on the same rotation. As long as you have Trunks Kid, Goten Kid, or Krillin on the team, then she'll get these additional boosts. So yeah, she's looking really good. Of course, her links are not as good as Goten and Trunks, so I think that's why. I mean, they don't have the best links either, but yeah, she definitely has worse links in comparison. So, I mean, I guess it's kind of even, maybe. I don't know. I think that they did a good job. I'm happy with how Android 18 turned out, for sure. And her stats with the EZA as well are really good. 16,543 attack when rainbowed, 16,859 HP, and 10,864 defense. Compared to Goten and Trunks, her stats are definitely, I would say, a little bit better. I mean, Trunks has more HP, but who really cares about HP? It does make a difference, don't get me wrong. Like, HP does help to keep you alive, you know, in those harder events. But at the end of the day, the most important thing to me is HP, attack and defense. And those both are quite high, especially the attack, man. 16,543 for a non-Dokkan Fest unit is a lot. So those are the three Extreme Z Awakenings coming with the Trunks and Goten Dokkan Fest. And one final thing we'll take a look at here. Oh, actually, I think I forgot to mention, since she gets a little bit more, boost for the support here, she's getting up to 360% attack when all conditions are met. Now, lastly, a lot of people are speculating that because we're getting these EZAs and the Goten and Trunks, that for Saiyan Day, they're setting us up for a Bio Broly Dokkan Fest, which would be interesting. It would definitely be interesting. I'm a little bit indifferent to this, to be completely honest. Oh, by the way, this is already in the game. This asset is actually the boss in the story event. So this art could be used for a summonable Bio Broly at some point. Maybe for Saiyan Day this year. We'll have to see. But as I said, man, I'm pretty neutral, I would say. If it's a Bio Broly, I think that'd be fine. But I would prefer a Super Saiyan God Goku. And I feel like my boy Kaba still needs more love, man. I mean, I don't think it's going to be a standalone Dokkan Fest Kaba, that's for sure. But one of these days, man, give us a new Kaba. Or even Kaba with Kale and Caulifla as like a trio unit. That'd be kind of cool. Anyways, maybe about Broly. It's pure speculation. It could be something else. We'll have to see. How would you guys feel about that? You know, I feel like Bio Broly, like the movie was obviously not as popular as the first two, right? And I don't know. Like it's different. It is different. So I guess that'd be cool. But yeah, I would still prefer something else. So we'll see. You know, whatever it is, I guess I'm good. If it's a Bio Broly, I'll still summon for it. I just won't be as happy as I could be. And that's going to be today's video, guys. Thank you so much for watching. Stay tuned for more details, I guess, for both the Goten and Trunks, as well as the Saiyan Day unit coming out in about 2 weeks from now. And as always, if you guys liked today's video, then make sure to like the damn video. And if it's your first time watching me, first time to the channel, and you like what you see, then definitely hit that big red subscribe button to join the Tiger Squad now. And while you're at it, hit that notification bell too, so that YouTube knows you want to stay up to date with all my latest content. And that's it. I'm out of here. Until next time, hope you guys have a fantastic, fantastic day. I'm Tiger with Tiger Uppercut Media, signing out.